got the whole world. In his head he's got this hole. Red in his head he's got this whole world. Red in his head he's got this whole wide world in his head. He's got the whole.
Oh yes, hallelujah. He got the whole world in his hands. Praise the Lord, hallelujah. Once again, I greet you in the name that's above every name. That name is Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God. Hallelujah. The Bible says he's the first and the last. The Bible says he's the beginning and the end. Hallelujah. God all by himself. In the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God, and the Word was God. Hallelujah. Not only that, the Word became flesh. Hallelujah. Became flesh to be a sacrificial offering for you and you and you. All at the sound of my voice, amen, in this telecast, amen. Yes, I am Pastor Warren J. Smith of the Main Gospel Church, amen. Known as the Gospel Rider, amen. Just letting you know that Jesus loves you. Amen. Hallelujah. And we have a foundation. The Bible is, it says the other foundation can no man lay. And that's laid, which is Jesus Christ. So it is about Jesus. He is the center of attraction. Amen. Here we are once again moving on. Amen. Saying what thus said the Lord and not what thus said the man. That's one Lord, one God, one faith, one baptism, one God, Father of us all. Hallelujah. Jesus said himself, he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. He said, no man go come it to the Father but by me. Hallelujah. So I submit to you tonight, I don't care, regardless of what you're going to, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house or many mansions, if it were not so, I would have told you. Amen. I'm gonna read this in your hearing. Amen. The Bible lets us know that we, as saints of God, as children of God, it says, let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth, but that which is good to the use of edifying. In other words, you ain't saying nothing, be quiet. Huh? If you ain't saying nothing about nothing good, be quiet. Hallelujah. It goes on, it says, which is good to the use of edifying, that it may minister grace unto the hearers. He that had the ear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the church. Amen. Yes, you are the church, the body of Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. And we ought to be with one accord as we go about preaching what thus said the Lord. Preachers, I tell you over and over and over, tell God's people the truth. Come out of that mess. It ain't about what you think. It ain't about your opinion. Amen. It's about what God's word says. That's what you are obligated to do. Amen. Hallelujah. Yes, he ordained you from your mother's womb. Amen. To preach and teach the truth. The truth, you should know it, and the truth shall make you free. To whom the Son set free is free indeed. Hallelujah. And it says, and grieve not the Holy Spirit of God, whereby ye are sealed grieve not the Holy Spirit of God, whereby you are sealed until the day of redemption. Let all bitterness, let all wrath, let all anger and calamity and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. Hallelujah. And it says this, watch this now, and be ye kind one to another, tenderhearted, forgiving one another, even as God, for Christ's sake, has forgiven you. Hallelujah. There's only one way, and that's God's way. Hallelujah. I would submit to you tonight to trust in the Lord with all of thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. Hallelujah. The Bible says the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. Hallelujah. Watch this now. The Bible says, it said, fret not thyself because of evildoers, neither be thy envious against the workers of iniquity. Why? Because they shall soon be cut down as the grass and withered as the green herb. There's only one way, and that's God's way. Hallelujah. And I can see that over and over and over. And the only thing I can tell you is what's true. I can't tell you nothing. It ain't my opinion. It ain't about me. Hallelujah. I'm just a vessel. Amen. And I'm submitting myself to God. Amen. Hallelujah. The Bible says, so let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Set your affections on things above and not on things on this earth. Amen. Hallelujah. You got to have the mind of Christ. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. Present your body a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto the Lord, which is your reasonable service. I got a clip I want you to hear now, and I want you to let somebody know, amen, to tune in and check this out, amen, and hear the man of God. Watch this. Listen to it.
Sin is death. That's without a doubt.
I'm not preaching.
If you sin, that the wages of sin is death. The Bible tells us that. Huh?
Amen.
The wages of sin is death. Amen. But guess what?
The guilt.
The gift.
Amen.
The
amen.
Gift didn't cost nothing. The gift of
yeah.
God is what?
Eternal life.
By who? Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That's true.
The only begotten Son of God. There is a way now. That folks think that they can have this, have that, other, and they don't even realize. See, a lot of times people think that a good man will just get you to heaven, being a good man. Ain't one good, and he's in heaven. Because you may be good here on this earth according to a certain group of people, but your goodness may be like a rejection to somebody else. Dear hearts, don't get it twisted. We have to worship God in spirit and in truth. That's our connection.
That's true.
Hallelujah. If you can't receive the Spirit of God, then you can deal with the flesh aspect. There is no fleshly aspect other than Jesus Christ when he suffered, bled, and died on the cross.
Amen.
But he's no longer on the cross today.
Right. That's it.
You remember how the story goes? They pissed him in the side, they whipped him up to here, and then they killed him, and he died. He hung his head and he died. But he rose from the dead.
Amen. That's right.
And see, if you got that connection, just like he rose from the dead. Now, we all know we all have an appointment with death, isn't it right? We're going to die one day. But just as Christ was raised from the dead, you also will walk in the newness of life when you die. So it's important that while you're alive, amen, to seek the Lord now while he may be found. Recognize that you worship him in spirit and in truth. Don't get caught up. The Bible said, don't bleed every spirit. Only the Spirit of God. Check it out and see if it's of God.
Amen.
We're living in some tedious times now. Things are not getting any better. And I'm going to say it again. I'm going to say it every week. It's going to get even worse than it just has been. Oh, yeah. We're living in the last days.
Amen.
Amen.
I said we're living in the last days.
Amen.
Now, I didn't say I was no prophet and I'm predicting anything, amen. Because I do know, as we learned last week, that a day could be 1,000 years with the Lord. But we're living in the last days. Evil times are upon us right now.
Amen.
Men, women, girls, and boys are creating their own type of way of worshiping God. Some of them don't even go to a body of Christ anywhere. They just take one day, don't even pray. Don't even give God thanks. I dare you to just sit back and think about all the things in your life and see how many things you can thank God for. Because there are some things that happen in your life that you know you wouldn't be there unless God had been with you.
Thank you, Jesus.
We cheated death a lot of times. Hallelujah. Let no man deceive you. 6th verse, 5th chapter of Ephesians. Let no man deceive you with vain words, for because of these things come the wrath of God upon the children of disobedience. Why is God sending this message to us today? Oh my Lord, why is God sending this message to us today? I'll tell you why. Because there are so many other ways that folks are trying to promote citizenship in heaven, and they don't even represent God. Now they'll say they represent God.
Time,
right? They'll say it.
Sure.
Yes, hallelujah. And it also says, be not ye therefore partakers with them. For ye were sometimes darkness, but now ye are the light in the Lord. Walk as children of light. For the fruit of the Spirit is in all goodness. For the fruit of the Spirit is in all righteousness. For the fruit of the Spirit is in all truth. Proving what is acceptable unto the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. And it says, look, have no fellowship with unfruitful works of darkness, but rather reprove them. In other words, hey man, you may be in a situation where a lot of stuff is going on that ain't right, but your light shines so bright, amen, it'll bring about conviction. That's why Jesus said, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Hallelujah. For it is a shame even to speak of those things which are done of them in secret. But all things that are reproved are made manifest by the light. And whatsoever doth make it manifest is light. You are the salt of the earth. I tell you that over and over and over. Hallelujah. You have a duty. You are obligated as a minister of the gospel to let your light shine that the world can see Christ in you. It should be something about you. Matter of fact, the Bible says you ought to be a walking epistle. You need to know the word. You need to know what you're talking about. You don't have to have all these other encyclopedias and everything else around when you done studied, amen, and showed yourself approved unto God, amen. All you need is what the word says, amen. The Holy Ghost will break it down, amen. Hallelujah. It will break it down, and Jesus or God's people will hear what's pertaining to them. Hallelujah. Didn't it not say, he that dwell in the secret place of the Most High shall do what? Abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he's my refuge, he's my fortress, he's my God. In him will I trust. Hallelujah. So let no man deceive you with vain words. They sound good, amen, and seem like it ought to be like that, amen. But don't forget, the Bible says there is a way that seems right unto man, but the end thereof are the ways of death. Hallelujah. So it's only one way, and it's God's way. Hallelujah. Jesus said, I am the way. Hallelujah. So I submit to you today, tonight, or wherever you are listening to this, to seek God now. Don't cost you anything. You are a chosen generation. You are a royal priesthood. You are peculiar people. In other words, it's something about you that separates you from the world. Amen. See, you're in the world, but you're not of the world. Amen. Hallelujah. And you ain't going to live forever. Amen. This is God's garden. Amen. He'll come and pluck a flower anytime he get ready. Oh, yes, he will. Your main thing is to be ready when he come. Hallelujah. So no matter how much what you call right to put behind wrong going to make anything right. I don't care how much what you call right going to make it right. No. The Bible says all unrighteousness is sin. and the wages of sin is death. Huh? Now that's the word. I'm giving you nothing but the word, amen. You can read it for yourself, amen. I ain't adding nothing to it, I ain't taking nothing away. I'm giving you what the word says. And it also says, beloved, believe not every spirit. Try the spirit and see whether it's of God. Check it out, amen. Hallelujah. Oh, yes, check it out and see whether it's of God. Why? Because many false spirits, false prophets, false teachers are going out into the world and telling you what thus says them. And what thus says them ain't got no heaven or hell to put nobody in. It ain't what I say, it ain't what bishops say, it ain't what you say. It's what God say that count. God's word will not return unto him void. Isaiah 55:11 says, so shall my word be that go forth out of my mouth, it shall not return unto me void. So I'm just telling you tonight, dear hearts, all wherever you are, it's one way. And that's God's way. Delight yourself also in the Lord, and he'll give you the desires of your heart. We're living in the last days. Look around and see. Hallelujah. Earthquakes in divers places, famine in the land, wars and rumor of wars, and all this stuff going, all these floods and pestilence and just all kind of stuff, violence and negativism all over the world, and all this confusion that's happening in the world, amen. Nobody can come together, amen. Why? Because anytime you exclude God, you have problems. So the most important thing you can do is include God in your life. Include God in your decisions. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, trust him. Hallelujah. He promised never to leave you nor forsake you. He'll be with you even to the end of the world. Hallelujah. Time is winding up. Amen. So it's high time, amen, to start standing for what's right. Hallelujah. See, Satan, he's a liar. He's the father of a lie. He come to kill, steal, and destroy. He come to make things look like they ought to be this way, ought to be that way. Amen. You need to check that out. And you know what? This is the sad thing is this. Some of you preachers, some of you missionaries, some of you bishops, y'all know better than that. I said you know better. Hallelujah. The Bible said, woe to the pastors that destroy and scatter the sheep of my pastor. Hallelujah. That's what the Bible tells us. It's a big woe there, amen. God forbid, I don't want that woe. That's why I'm going to tell you what thus says the Lord. Now, if I ain't got nothing else to say about it, I ain't got nothing else to say. Hallelujah. All I have for you, amen, is the word of God. The word that I've hid in my heart that I might not sin against thee. Amen. So that's all I have to give you, amen. But you know what? You ain't going to live forever. The Bible tells us it is appointed unto man once to die, after that the judgment. So once you die, it's too late. Don't let too late catch you. Amen. Now you can do all the good you want to do, but they can't preach you into heaven. No, they got all these obituaries and say all these good things, amen, while you laying out there in your fine suit and all this type of stuff and looking all good and pretty and all that. God knows your life. God knows your life. Hallelujah. He made you. And ain't nothing you go through that God can't handle. So I submit to you, seek the Lord while he may be found. Get out of this mess, amen. This world is just it's chaotic, amen. Look at the mess they fighting over, amen. It is so sickening. It's so sad, amen. We're living in some violent times, dear hearts. Some wicked times, hallelujah. Oh, yes, hallelujah. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of darkness of this world. And see, that's what's taking over right now. But God is not the author of confusion, but he is the author of peace. He said, my peace I leave with you. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, my God. Bless the Lord, oh, my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Hallelujah. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy come in the morning. You may be having a good time or a bad time tonight, amen. But just hold on. God got something coming on your way to make your day. Remember, the joy of the Lord is your strength. Hallelujah. I say the joy of the Lord is your strength. Hallelujah. So I submit to you tonight, hearken to the voice of the Lord. Did not Jesus say, he that had an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the church? That's what the word tells us. Jesus said, my sheep know my voice. A stranger they will not find. That's what the word tells us. Hallelujah. So don't get caught up in all these different type of things going on and all these big functions and everything. This is a mess. This is ridiculous. Hallelujah. And church folk caught right up in it. Amen. Can you imagine? Can you imagine all the stuff that we see going on? Amen. And because they say Jesus or they mention God, we think God or Jesus is in it. You better check it out. The devil say Jesus. The devil say God. You better check it out. Huh? See, God ain't in that foolishness. Huh? And some of them, I got the feeling, amen, they really don't believe God exists. And the fool says in his heart, there is no God. Now, the fool says that. You can say whatever you want to say. But see, the fool says there is no God in his heart, amen. He really don't care what he say. He ain't got you in mind. He don't care how you do, what you do, when you do. All he want is the financial earnings that he get from it. Filthy lucre. Hallelujah. It ain't nothing wrong with the money, but the love of it. That's the key. The love of money is the root of all evil. And it didn't say some evil. It said all evil. Amen. So I just submit to you tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. Stand firm. Have your lines girded about with truth. Amen. That's what you're going to know. That's what's going to make you free. And you won't be entangled with the yoke of bondage. Amen. Because he brought you out of darkness. Yes. Into his marvelous light. As I say over, and I say it again, over and over. God is in absolute, complete control. Huh? It ain't what you or I say. We don't have a say, amen. No. Thank God for the way that he have connections to tune in with some man, a woman, a God that can preach the gospel and tell you that had an ear to hear what the Spirit says to the church, amen. Because you ain't getting this everywhere. You ain't getting it everywhere. Huh? I say you are not getting the truth everywhere. Uh-huh. They'll start off in the Bible, but then they'll go off to something else. Huh? And they are the ones that really just want to put what they feel like you ought to hear. But the Word of God tells us, let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare, that's Jesus, a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself. Hallelujah. So I'm telling you tonight, amen, hearken to the voice of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hearken to the voice of the Lord. Hallelujah. Look what it says here in the book of Isaiah, 45th chapter. It says, thus said the Lord to his anointed, to Cyrus, whose right hand I have holden, to subdue the nations before him, and I will loose the lions of kings to open before him the two levered gates, and the gates shall not be shut. I will go before thee and make the crooked places straight. I will break in pieces the gates of brass and cut into some of the bars of iron, and I will give thee the treasures of darkness and the hidden riches of the secret places, that thou mayest know that I am the Lord. Whew, hallelujah. Which call thee by thy name, I am the God of Israel. One God, one Lord, one faith. I formed the light and created the darkness. I made peace. Hallelujah. And created evil. Hallelujah. I just want you to know, amen, hallelujah, God is in control of it all, dear hearts. Hallelujah. And remember, a good name is always better than precious ornament. Amen. Hallelujah. So don't never have your good evil spoken of. Do that you know to do that's right in the sight of God. Hallelujah. I ain't say nothing about being holier than thou. No. We were delivered from sin by the grace of God. For by grace are we saved through faith. That's the gift of God. Not of works, lest any man should boast. And all unrighteousness is sin. And the wages of sin is death. But the gift, hallelujah, the gift of God, eternal life through Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God. Hallelujah. So I just want you to know tonight, amen, God loves you. Amen. His foundation is holy. He cares for you, and he is certainly concerned for you and your needs. Amen. Hallelujah. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried in the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof. Hallelujah. God is in control of all of that. Hallelujah. So I submit to you today, amen. Seek the Lord now while he may be found, and call upon him while he is yet near. Oh, yes, amen. In closing, amen, I want to say the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came up to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell. Though an host shall encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war shall rise against me, in this will I be confident. One thing have I desired of the Lord, and that will I seek after. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. That I will dwell in the house of the Lord and to inquire into his temple. Hallelujah. For in the time of trouble, he should hide me in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me upon a rock. Hallelujah. Hey, hallelujah. If God be for you, can't nobody be against you. Hallelujah. As my dear sister Mahalia get ready, amen, I want you to know this. This is Pastor Warren J. Smith. I pastor the Main Gospel Church. Amen. You can write me at Post Office Box 470070, Los Angeles, California, 90047. Hallelujah. You write me, I'll write you back. Amen. I'm going to say that again. That's Post Office Box 470070, Los Angeles, California, 90047. Also known as the Gospel Rider. Amen. Hallelujah. That means I get on the motorcycle, I ride through the alley, through the highways, byways, and whomever, wherever God send me, just to remind them that Jesus loves you. Hallelujah. So just remember that. Amen. Just remember, God is, as always, in absolute, complete control. I say God is, hallelujah, and he's whatever you want him to be. So trust in the Lord with all of your heart and lean not into your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. And remember, it ain't what I say, it's what the Bible say, the word of God. Hallelujah. God says that there's no other name given among men under heaven whereby we must be saved, for it is at the name of Jesus every knee shall bow and every tongue must confess that Jesus is Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus is Lord. Hallelujah. So seek the Lord now while he may be found, and call upon him while he is yet near. Hallelujah. Because, dear heart, God loves you, God cares for you, and God is concerned. Come on, Sister Mahalia, bring me on home. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ.
fly.